Hello, I'm Ty Mason of the DiabetesCouncil.com, researcher, writer, and I have type 2 diabetes. Today I'm going to answer the question, is hemp oil good for diabetes? But before we get into that, make sure you download my free diabetes management book, which also includes a diabetes grocery shopping guide, foods to eat and avoid, by clicking the link below. Now I know there are some of you, when you saw the word hemp in the description title, you clicked on this video hoping I would say, yes, hemp is awesome for diabetes. Well, I may yet say that, but there is something you need to know right up front. There's a big difference between hemp and marijuana. They are in the same plant family, cannabis, but they are totally different. You see, the ingredient in cannabis that makes you high is THC. In hemp oil, the THC content is about 0.3%, hardly enough to give you a buzz. Now that we've got that out of the way, let's take a look at hemp seed oil, or hemp oil as it's also known. Hemp oil is produced by cold pressing the seeds and then extracting the oil. Cold pressing means the temperature of the seeds never exceeds 120 degrees Fahrenheit. This keeps the oil extracted from losing nutritional value and flavor. Now, I found numerous articles claiming that hemp oil can cure everything from ingrown toenails to diabetes to cancer. But the articles were found on sites like healthyhempoil.com, rollonceup.com, and cannajournal.com. Now, I'm not saying these are bad websites, but I am saying they have an interest in selling their product, and they lack the scientific data that my research needs in order to be satisfied. Not to say it isn't out there, but I was not able to find a definitive scientific study to say that hemp oil could cure any disease. I did find that hemp seeds are a great source of protein, polyunsaturated fatty acids, omega-6, omega-3s, and insoluble fiber. They're loaded with minerals such as potassium, magnesium, iron, zinc, calcium, and phosphorus. However, hemp oil is also loaded with alpha-linolenic acid, or ALA, and omega-3 fatty acid. Now, if you saw our video on fish oil, you may know that those of us with diabetes can have trouble converting the ALA, as it's called, which can lead to an increase in our triglycerides, and that's definitely not good for our heart. Now, I want you to note that there are two ALA fatty acids. I know that's confusing, but if you're going to Google ALA, you need to make sure you're talking about alpha-linolenic acid, not alpha-lipoic acid. Alpha-lipoic acid is great for diabetics because it helps lower our blood sugar and our insulin sensitivity. But they're not the same. The ALA in hemp oil is alpha-linolenic acid. So, is hemp oil good for diabetes? Well, I will say it can be, but it also can be bad, simply because each individual cannot know how their body will react to the alpha-linolenic acid. Other than that, it has some great stuff for your body. So I'm going to have to refer this one to your healthcare provider. There are some factors that need to be taken into account, especially your triglyceride levels. I know I kind of passed the buck there a little bit, but I hope this answered your question, is hemp oil good or bad for diabetes? Don't forget to get your diabetes management book by clicking the link in the description box below. And as always, if you have any other diabetes-related questions, just let me know. Thank you for watching so much. I'm Ty Mason.